haven't seen this much snow this winter, but when the white stuff starts falling, every student at one Noblesville school will be able to enjoy playing outside in it, thanks to some of their classmates. When the girls realized not everyone had winter gear, they took it upon themselves to make sure no one was left out in the cold. And coming up tonight at 5, we'll show you how they got it done through what they called Operation Snow Fun. But right now, I'm joined by Elizabeth Sons from MHS to talk more about how you can make a difference in your community. And Elizabeth, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you for having me, yeah.
So there are several ways that people can connect with others and get involved.
Absolutely. You know, our communities have to constantly be evolving to thrive and to improve. And there's lots of things we can do, just from simply changing your attitude to make a situation from negative to positive, or changing your diet to make some more healthy habits. You know, there's lots of things you can do to improve and make change. So I've put together a few concepts for you.
Okay.
To kind of talk about how we can do that kind of change.
Okay.
So the first is to choose a cause and create a goal. You know, our student leaders chose to help out their peers when they saw a specific need, and it's important to pick a cause you believe in to create change. Once you have a cause you believe in, write out a goal for what changes you want to see and how you plan to accomplish that. The second is to connect and educate. Connecting with others who you feel will support or be impacted by your cause and who will be able to assist you in reaching your goal. Educate those around you on the issues you want to see change in and why that's important to you. And the last concept is to select the right action tools, whether that's to fundraise for your cause, find a grant, or to reach out to leadership to change a policy or to even create a new one. And select what tools you'll need to create action towards the change you want to see. You know, the students in our package really found an issue that they saw was negatively impacting their peers and made that change. But even you and I can do small things like making conversation with someone we don't know very well, or, you know, taking the stairs instead of the elevator. So definitely small things can make big impact.
Yeah, and you talked about choosing a cause. I mean, how can we wrap our minds around choosing what cause is important to us?
Absolutely. You know, I think it's all about seeing your environment and understanding what's affecting those people around you. You know, these students saw that their friends really needed something to be able to play with them, and they wanted them to feel included.
Yeah, and that's important, though, to make sure everyone feels as though they are included.
Absolutely.
Right?
Social isolation can be a big factor, not only for your mental health, but your physical health as well. So we want to make sure everyone feels included.
All right. Thanks again so much, Elizabeth Sons with MHS. And again, we will have much more on Operation Snow Fun coming up tonight on Eyewitness News at 5:30. Now, for more resources and to see our other stories, just head over to WTHR.com/aseatatthetable.